Holden dealers around the country are tonight trying to work out how they can remain in business. Some of the company's direct staff have been thrown a lifeline by rival Ford. But as Lana Murphy discovered, for the majority, the future is bleak.
For 69 years, Cecil Leeschke has lived and breathed Holden.
Yours truly right there.
Trained at Fisherman's Bend before taking over the family business. Now his is one of 185 dealerships that could be left on the scrap heap.
There'll be a void that we won't be able to fill.
Had the rug pulled out underneath our feet. So we've got the Nissan product. So do we get another franchise or what do we do?
They still stand a chance, but direct Holden employees don't. Work at the Lang Lang Proving Ground will wrap up by August.
The company will engage with the government about the future of the infrastructure at the Lang Lang Proving Ground.
500 roles, many in research and design, will cease mid-year. 90 staff members will be redeployed overseas and 200 will be retained to honour the 10-year service promise to some of the 1.6 million Holden in circulation.
All the resources that have gone into training, the development and research are now going to be lost in Australia.
Also lost will be the naming rights for Collingwood Football Club's home base and the NRL's state of origin. Both sponsorship deals were due to lapse at the end of this year. Today Holden confirmed it will honour that commitment for the next 9 months. Its future in supercars is less certain.
Commodore will be maintained on our grids, certainly to finish this year off, and what happens in 2021 I would think would be the same.
Racing bosses optimistic General Motors will roll out a new generation vehicle to keep the rivalry alive.
I'm meeting with GM this week and we'll discuss what happens.
Lana Murphy, Nine News.